If you need to edit photos for your business, this is the fastest way to get professional results online. Today, I'm going to show you how to create marketing-ready images with Adobe Express in minutes using one of the best online photo editors for quick edits. I'm Phil Pallen. Welcome to my channel where I share practical advice to help you build and grow your brand. Today, we're using Adobe Express to edit photos for marketing content. I'm excited to partner with them for this video because their photo editor is simple, powerful, and free to use. Adobe Express is a free photo editor for social media and more, and a fast way to turn photos into branded content. I'm going to walk you through how I edit photos online using quick actions, adjustments, filters, AI tools, Lightroom integration, Generative Expand, and even advanced add-ons. So let's get into it. Let's start with quick actions. These are perfect for beginners and for anyone needing fast results without getting lost in menus. They're one of the best entry points into Adobe Express for easy photo editing online. Here's where you find quick actions in Adobe Express, a purple plus sign, and then the quick actions menu. There are lots here, by the way. We can even filter by photo. And here you'll get one-click tools for common tasks and edits, perfect for when you need fast results without opening a full editor. So let's look at a few. Remove background isolates your subject instantly, which is great for product photos, headshots, or graphics that you want to place on a new background. Trust me, you don't want to do this by hand like I used to have to, especially with hair. It's really tough. But check this out. It looks amazing on a completely different background. This is an awesome feature. Crop image lets you trim your photo down to the exact framing that you want. You've got a few options, by the way. I might try square, or I might even try landscape. I could also try freeform and crop it however I want. I like to use this to remove empty space, tighten my composition, or focus the viewer's attention. Resize image helps you format your content for each social platform. You can choose the aspect ratio and find common social platforms like Instagram, which I'll select for this example of an adorable dog. But it's also got TikTok, YouTube, Pinterest, LinkedIn, and others, and optimal dimensions for these platforms handled for you. In this case, this size works for stories, but not for my feed, so I'll select portrait, which works perfectly. Now, another feature I love is being able to adjust the quality. Maybe I'm saving this image for my website, and I want my site to load quickly, so I'll slide the quality slider accordingly and download it. Big fan of that dog, so we're gonna use him again for this next quick action. I downloaded him as a JPEG, but convert to PNG is useful for when you need that file format. PNG is great for retaining transparency or higher quality export for design projects. Think graphics, branded elements, or even layered content. If you need a JPEG, by the way, they're great for lightweight sharing in emails or on the web, that's here. Or an SVG, which is a vector file, common for icons or anything that you need to scale without losing quality, that's here. The final quick action to show you for this demo is Profile Photo Maker. It enhances your headshot automatically for using it as a profile photo. See how it crops it, offers a variety of backgrounds to choose from. Some of these are wild. And when creating a profile photo for social media, for email signatures, or for your website, this is definitely one to check out. So those are a few of my favorite quick actions ideal for free online photo editing for social media. Next, I want to show you my favorite way to edit. Start from your own content. In this case, it could be your own photo. No templates, there are no distractions. It's really just a nice, clean workspace built around your image. Here's how Start From Your Content works. You can import your photo directly, JPEG, PNG, even Photoshop files, so PSD or PDFs with layers. Those separate layers will be retained. Once you choose your image, I'll use a JPEG for this. We'll select Edit Original Image. Adobe Express will then build an entire project around it. Learn content on the right if you're curious, and then controls on the left that we'll walk through together shortly. Start From Your Content is a great workflow for product shots, brand photography, which is what I'm using it for here, maybe speaker photos, thumbnails, even lifestyle images. Something you've created outside of Express works. Maybe it's a design where the photo leads. And if you want to explore templates, you can still add them later by clicking that option from the menu. Starting From Your Content simply keeps the focus on the image first and makes it easy to turn photos into branded content without overwhelm. Now, let's refine the image using the Edit menu. This is where beginners, like my clients, get comfortable fast, and where marketers, like me, get the control they need. Here's the Edit panel. This is where you can make detailed adjustments to your photo. We'll come back to some of these powerful AI features momentarily. For now, I want to start with the basics under Adjust. Here, you'll find controls for light, color, and detail, so contrast, brightness, highlights, and shadows. There are lots of them in this image, as well as saturation, warmth, and then sharpen and blur. Essentially, everything you need to fine-tune the lighting and color of your image. For product photos, textures, or anything that needs a crisper edge, I'm a big fan of using Sharpen. And obviously, Blur can soften backgrounds or add depth when you want the subject to stand out. In this example, we could use a combination of Remove Background, similar to the quick action that we saw earlier. I'll duplicate this photo layer, remove background on the top layer, and then add Blur to the background for that softness that I mentioned. Now, let's say we want to crop this image. We can. Maybe we want to use this on my website. I might want to add a new page here and adjust that size of the page to square. Then I can copy over my photo and work with it on this new page. And I can do all of this in the same project in Adobe Express, up to 100 pages. You also have tools here like corners to round the edges of your image, position to align or layer elements on your canvas, even flip, and opacity if you want to create softer overlays or even integrate your photo into another design. These tools make it simple to crop, adjust, and enhance photos for any marketing use without needing advanced editing skills. In fact, I find myself using Adobe Express daily for most of my content needs. If I need something more complex like high-end retouching, I open Adobe Photoshop, or intricate recoloring, I might open Adobe Lightroom. Together, they cover everything from quick social graphics to detailed creative work. Within Adobe Express, these tools make it simple to crop, adjust, and enhance photos for any marketing use. If you want to add style to your photo quickly, the Effects panel is the place to explore. These filters come straight from Adobe's ecosystem. Let's work with a new photo for this example. Here's my entire design team photographed working on a branding project. Okay, we're improvising a bit for a photo shoot, but that's what it's supposed to look like. Watch how we can apply some Photoshop filters directly in Adobe Express. And there are many here when you click View All. Definitely explore these. They won't all be right, but the more you experiment, the more comfortable you'll become with all the possibilities here. And note that you can click into any of these filters and make adjustments to the intensity. I love how this is looking. We can also adjust tones like grayscale, darken, tint, and colorize. That's fun. Duotone is a style I've used for branding projects in the past, where we're working with different types of photography, applying consistent duotones, like maybe brand colors, in a way that creates a uniform look across all of them. Think speaker photos on a conference website. Different photographers have taken the headshots of each speaker, but applying a duotone filter makes them all feel part of the same collection. Choose from preset options or customize it for yourself, in this case, leaning on my own brand colors, which I have set up in Adobe Express in my brand kit. Finally, let's talk about shadows. I'll shrink the size of my photo down so you can see the different style options, which apply to the entire element, in this case, the photo. I'll use position, centered, to make sure it's centered. And now let's look at the different shadow options. I could see myself adding these if I'm putting these visuals into a presentation or onto a website. Again, fully customizable for my needs, custom and classic options for simple depth or clean cutouts. These effects help you create marketing-ready visuals without heavy editing. Now, let's use AI to clean up and enhance your image. These tools are incredibly useful for marketers, especially if you're working with imperfect photos. Here are the AI tools under the Object Editing panel. Remove Object lets you erase distractions with natural fill, so it analyzes the surrounding area and blends everything seamlessly, which is incredibly helpful for cleaning up backgrounds, removing clutter, or fixing small imperfections. Sometimes, if that area that you're removing is big enough, the AI will infer what it thinks you might want to add. Sometimes things I didn't even think about, like this bird. But rest assured, you can continue generating until you're happy, like in this case, removing the object, the woman holding the frame, entirely. Now I'm going to undo that because I want to show you Insert Object. This adds new elements directly into your scene. Maybe you want to bring in props, textures, or supporting visuals to build out the environment in a way that feels intentional. I think we should add some modern art into this empty frame that she's holding. holding. I think this is great for when you want to enhance a product shot or add visual interest without reshooting the photo. That art is looking great. Okay, Generate Similar gives you alternative versions of your image, something totally different that you can describe in a prompt, and it uses your original photo as a starting point and creates variations with different compositions or backgrounds. Maybe I love the colors and the qualities of this image. You can see how it inspires our cabin in the woods. This might be useful if you want more options to choose from without taking new photos. Let's keep both for our final example, which should already be familiar to you. Remove background remains one of the easiest ways to isolate your subject. It gives you a clean cutout that you can place onto new backgrounds, templates, or branded layouts, all with one click. We're gonna put our girl holding the frame on the balcony of the cabin, although I think her feet are gonna be cold out in the snow. You can see how not only can you have some fun with these AI-powered editing tools, but they're serious too. These can make everyday photo editing faster and more flexible, especially when you're preparing images for marketing content and you want them to look polished without a complicated workflow. These tools can help you edit photos for social media content quickly and accurately. If you use Adobe across your workflow, this next part is truly game-changing. Adobe Express connects seamlessly with Lightroom, your personal uploads, projects, and libraries. If you use Adobe across your workflow, you will love this part. Adobe Express connects seamlessly with Lightroom, your personal uploads, projects, libraries, so all your assets are right here where you need them. So how to access these inside Adobe Express? In your stuff. Files, shows uploads, Adobe Express projects, images, videos, and more, whatever you've added or modified recently will show first. And here's something many people don't know. You can also open and edit linked Photoshop files right here from Adobe Express. If you upload a PSD or find one that you've opened recently, here under Files, Express creates a connected version of that asset. So let's place it on my canvas, and then when you click Open in Photoshop Web, you can make changes directly in your browser. When you hit Save and return to Adobe Express, you'll see an update prompt. Your change syncs in real time, and every instance of that graphic in your project updates automatically, as long as it's linked. This is ideal if you want the flexibility of Photoshop for detailed edits while still designing and exporting everything in Adobe Express. The two tools complement each other beautifully, giving you a workflow that's powerful but still fast and accessible. Let's keep looking through your stuff. Next, projects are a place where you and your team can share files, brands, libraries, and more. Everything is housed within them, like brands and libraries folders, even custom templates here and files. Libraries span Creative Cloud apps, so you can access them across Adobe Express, Photoshop, and many other Adobe tools that you know and love. You might house assets for a particular campaign your team is collaborating on across different Creative Cloud apps. That would make sense. Favorites are any design assets that you've hearted, making it easy to come back and reference these later. Maybe things that you've seen in stock, photos, videos, templates, you get the idea. Finally, your Lightroom photos are stored on this tab. You can pull in your edited images straight from Lightroom without exporting or downloading anything. Everything syncs so you can work across devices without manual uploads, making Adobe Express a strong photo editor for marketers. Okay, this next feature is one of my favorites, Generative Expand. In branding, in my world, this solves a common issue. Your great photo doesn't always fit the format that you need. Let's use this image as an example. Pretend this is a hero image for a brand campaign. That's definitely what it looks like. It's wide, it's cinematic, perfect for a website header. But what if you need a taller version for this same photo for a web section? Let's say you're going to put some text over top, maybe a landing page block or a vertical social post. Normally, you'd have to crop out important details here or rebuild the composition entirely, but here's where Generative Expand inside Resize makes all the difference. Click Resize and then switch to a taller format. You've got so many options to choose from here. Now, instead of stretching or cutting the image, Generative Expand fills in the extra space above and below the image. For this option to be available, make sure your image spans either left to right and or top to bottom. It needs to stretch the full way in one direction at least. So you can see here it matches the sky, the haze, the mountains, all with subtle gradients and textures. And I've got a few options as with all Adobe Firefly generated results. So the expanded canvas here feels like part of the original photo, which I love. You keep the full storytelling moment of the person standing on the edge, arms raised in victory, while Adobe Express builds a taller version around it. It gives you more real estate for web layouts, text overlays, or campaign messaging, all without needing a reshoot. That's what Generative Expand does. It lets you adapt a single photo into every format you might need, all while staying on brand and keeping the integrity of the original shot. So think about how you can repurpose content and images in unconventional ways. Maybe you go from horizontal to vertical for Instagram, TikTok, YouTube thumbnails, really any platform with a different aspect ratio. You're gonna get a clean, professional layout tailored to each channel, and each visual storytelling stays consistent across the whole campaign. Finally, for those who want even more control, the Add-Ons Marketplace in Adobe Express gives you advanced tools that you can layer on top of your existing workflow. Here's how the Add-Ons Marketplace looks. This is where you can extend Adobe Express with extra tools that fit your workflow. Let me show you an example of one in action. Text Eraser is great for removing unwanted text that is baked into an image. Just upload the image with text, like this example, and give a few moments for it to process, and then, as it promises, the text is removed. Just like that. Now, I'm not gonna demo all of these, but let me call out a few that I think might be useful for your photo editing workflow. Mask Maker is great for shape-based masks. Pixel Enhancer for improved image clarity. Revive Old Photo for reviving old or blurry images. Or Image Upscaler saves AI for upscaling low-resolution images using advanced AI. One thing to note, add-ons are completely free to access, but some of them are freemium, which means they'll give you a credit or two to actually try the tool out before requiring a paid subscription. But also, some of them are completely free, so it just depends. You'll see pricing or trial labels on each add-on as you browse, so you always know what's included before you use it. What's nice is that add-ons expand Adobe Express without changing the simple editing experience that we've already looked at. Everything stays in the same interface. You just gain more capabilities. It gives you the flexibility of a more advanced editor while still keeping the speed and ease of a free online photo editor with templates built in. Okay, that's how to edit photos for marketing content using Adobe Express. You saw how easy it is to start with quick actions, refine your photo, apply filters, use AI tools, integrate Lightroom, expand your image, and explore add-ons. All of this, by the way, free and easy to learn with a free photo editor for social media that makes it simple to edit photos for marketing content. If you found this useful, let me know in the comments what feature that you're gonna try first. I'm so excited to know. I'll reply to as many of those as I can. I'm Phil Pallen. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.